Welcome back, Sethling here. If you've never seen this program before, this is MC Edit. It's a tool that you can use to edit your levels in Minecraft. What this video is really about is biomes, and more specifically, it's about a plugin that I wrote for MC Edit, or a filter actually it's called, that will allow you to set the biomes for any part of your map that you want. So for instance, I've selected this chunk of grass here. I'll just hit filter. I'll go down to the set biome filter. That's the filter that I wrote. And in here is a list of all 21 different biomes. I'm going to go ahead and pick swamp and then hit filter, and every single column in this chunk will get a biome type of filter. Now it doesn't matter how tall or short I made this selection, because biome data is actually stored per column, so no matter how tall or short it was, the data would get stored into the column. So there's actually a lot of cool stuff you can do when you're able to set the biomes. Let me hop into this map, and I'll save, and then I'll hop in and show you what kind of cool stuff you can do. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at that world that I was just working on. So we can see all the grass chunks here. There's some zombie pigment over here, but I'll get to that in a bit. Over here is the swamp chunk that we created. If I press F3, you can see over on the left side it says swampland. That's how you know it's a swamp chunk. You can also see the discolored grass. I prepared a bunch of chunks with different biomes. Like over here, there's a desert. Over here, there's taiga. This is a mushroom island biome, and you can see that there's the mushroom spawning here. And here's plains. This one is hell. That's a pretty interesting one. And then there's also sky right here. And in the sky one, actually, the sky turns all dark. If you raise your altitude a bit, it's a bit different, but it's kind of an interesting one. So probably the most useful one for map makers is this one over here, the mushroom island biome, or mushroom biome as it's commonly referred to. Now the cool thing about this biome is that the only mob that can spawn is mushrooms. That's it. And so you don't have any aggressive mobs. If you don't have any grass or mycelium, no mobs are going to spawn in this, so that's really useful for maps that really want to control what types of mobs will spawn. Now, spawners still work, mob spawners, and then spawn eggs also still work. So you can still have like stuff like Pit Frenzy or whatever else, but there's just not going to be any natural spawns from either passive or hostile mobs, which is very, very cool. I expect this to be used by a lot of map makers. I'm going to be using it in a lot of my maps. Probably the next most useful one for map makers is this desert one over here. The cool thing about this is, of course, weather or rain, is of course that rain doesn't happen in this one. So, you know, you have rain over here, there's snow in the taiga biome. There's actually no rain here in the sky biome, but in this one, passive mobs won't spawn, but normal mobs like skeleton zombies, they will spawn. So this is useful for stuff like Race for the Wool, where you don't want rain and you also don't want passive mobs spawning. This one's taiga, it's pretty normal, plains, let me turn off the weather. This one is the hell biome, and this is actually the biome that's used in the nether, and that's why all the zombie pigmen are spawning, as you might have guessed. Also, there's a gas somewhere that I can hear, yep, over there. Gas will spawn in this biome too. So, this is kind of cool, because if you want to put a little chunk of nether in your main world, you can actually do it. You don't have to go to the Nether to get the Nether mobs to spawn. Magma cubes will also spawn in this biome. It's a pretty cool one. You can place water normally and ice and everything. Ice isn't going to melt. Everything behaves the same except for mob spawns, but you won't get normal mob spawning in this biome. This one, the sky biome, is the biome that's used in the end. So if I turn it to nighttime, we'll start to see Enderman spawning here, and also you have that cool sky effect, so it's a little bit different. It's like pretty dark in the sky, as opposed to if I leave the sky biome, it's much lighter. So it just adds a bit darker. It's pretty cool. It'd be pretty cool for like a space map or something. But yep, here's all the Endermen spawning. You're not going to get any other mobs than Endermen here. This might be useful also if you want to have a little chunk of the end in your overworld map. But yeah, a ton of zombie pigmen spawning in the hell biome. Anyway, so this is the kind of stuff that you can do. There's I think it's really useful because you can actually control down to the block what biome. So if you wanted a checkerboard pattern of desert and taiga for some reason, you could do it. It would probably be pretty time consuming to do with my filter because you can only select rectangular regions. But if you want to download the filter for yourself and try it out, you can just get it from the video description. It's a Python file. All you have to do is put that in the filters folder in your MCEdit installation, and it will appear in the filters list like I showed earlier in this video. So, a lot of great uses for this filter. I've been looking for a way to do this for a long time. I know other map makers have too, so hopefully we'll start to see this stuff used in map and really improve map qualities coming up soon. So, thanks for watching.